The year was 1900. The world population stood at around 1.6 billion, and the life expectancy of a newborn at the time was only 32 years. Fast forward to today, we have a global population of more than 8 billion people, and the average life expectancy has more than doubled to an incredible 73 years. Some call it the greatest achievement in human history, as we're seeing more and more people live well into their 90s and even past the incredible 100 centenarian mark. Hey, I'm Regis, and today on Good News, we'll take a look at why humans will break the current limits of life expectancy. Prior to the medical advancements of the 20th century, the average lifespan of humans remained pretty stagnant. Research shows that Paleolithic people from 12,000 years ago already had a life expectancy of around 33 years, roughly the same as someone born in the year 1900. So why did this number stay unchanged for so long? One reason is that childhood mortality rates used to be pretty high. Before the mid-1800s, people of course didn't have the public health services that we have today. Deadly diseases and global malnutrition kept the general life expectancy fairly low. Multiple smallpox pandemics, as well as the notorious bubonic plague, cut hundreds of millions of human lifespans short. But that was all about to change. In 1796, Dr. Edward Jenner successfully created the smallpox vaccine. Mandatory smallpox vaccinations were rolled out globally by the 1840s. And the development of vaccines for all kinds of fatal diseases soon followed. Recent studies suggest that vaccinations have contributed to a 40% decrease in global childhood mortality rates. Another game-changing discovery in the field of medicine was, of course, antibiotics. The first antibiotic, salvarsan, was put to use in 1910 to successfully treat deadly infections like syphilis and relapsing fever. Scientists calculate that antibiotics alone have increased our lifespans by as much as 23 years in just the past century. Further advancements in medicine and the use of medical technology to detect and diagnose illnesses have greatly affected mortality rates in every age group. This, along with better public healthcare practices like having clean water, sanitation, and better nutrition, led to longer lifespans that naturally increased our average life expectancy. In fact, the data shows that centenarians are a rapidly growing age group. The number of people 100 years old and older in the United States is set to quadruple in the next 30 years, from 100,000 people to about 420,000. 100 years sounds like an incredible age to us, but many animals in nature live even longer than that. Bowhead whales can live for 200 years due to having much better DNA repair, while Greenland sharks can potentially grow to the ripe old age of 500 years. One assumption is that this is due to their very slow digestion. Discoveries such as these can help unlock our own biological aging secrets. Before we dive into the remarkable ways humans are using all this knowledge to try and increase life expectancy, we should keep in mind the influence of our genetics. We've long known that some genes carry with them the likelihood of developing life-threatening conditions, including type 2 diabetes and heart diseases. Studies also show that people whose parents and grandparents live a longer life are also more likely to live longer. The good news, however, is that recent studies reveal that genetics only account for between 10 and 20% of variation in human longevity. Thanks to better and more readily available medical services, many predisposed illnesses are also more treatable than ever before. All these factors have contributed to scientists estimating that theoretically, we can all live well past the age of 100. A study published in 2021 found that the biological so-called hard limit on human longevity is around 150 years. But what exactly is needed for us to go beyond 100 years and to even possibly break this hard limit? To answer this question, let's take a look at five crucial factors when it comes to prolonging life. The first of these is, of course, medicine. It might be easier these days to grow older than ever before, but we still need to deal with killer diseases like cancers. But a revolutionary new method has the potential to change how we treat the Big C. Commonly referred to as a personalized cancer vaccine, it uses the same mRNA technology found in many of the COVID-19 vaccines. A key advantage of this method is that it can be personalized by sequencing an individual's tumor DNA to design a vaccine tailored to their specific cancer mutations. New trials have shown that people with melanoma who took the vaccine along with an immunotherapy drug had their risk of death slashed in half compared to those who only took the drug. With new practices like this, we might be able to cure cancers in the future, and by doing so, we would massively increase our average life expectancy. Medical professionals are also working hard to tackle other diseases, such as Alzheimer's. There are more than 10 million new cases of Alzheimer's disease globally each year. Those living with it have a lower average life expectancy since it causes a weaker immune system. By the time a person develops Alzheimer's, they have a life expectancy of only 8 to 10 years. In July of this year, the United States Food and Drug Administration approved a new drug called Kisunla that targets amyloid plaques in the brains of people with early onset Alzheimer's. Removing amyloid has been shown to slow cognitive decline in patients. The long-term effects after discontinuing the medication are still being studied, though. More studies are needed, and there's no magical solution to completely halt Alzheimer's yet. While these scientists are looking to cure diseases, others are researching about directly prolonging a human's life. Rapamycin is an immunosuppressive drug commonly used in organ transplants. Some medical researchers believe that rapamycin could also be used for anti-aging purposes. Once again, further studies are needed to prove that rapamycin actually works for this purpose, but even so, dozens of medical practitioners in the United States are already using it in anti-aging treatment. What we put inside our bodies is vital to both our short and long-term health. That's why a key factor in improving populations' life expectancy is to focus on nutrition. Ever heard of a term called blue zones? It refers to areas around the globe where there are more centenarians and super centenarians, which are people 110 years and older, compared to the rest of the world. Okinawa in Japan, for instance, has 5 times more centenarians than there are in Western countries. Other blue zones include the Greek island of Icaria and the Mediterranean island of Sardinia. These longevity zones share many commonalities when it comes to nutrition. They enjoy a low-meat, high plant-based diet, consume healthy fats from olives, nuts, and seeds, and generally stay away from processed food. The finding here seems to be that the more natural the food, the better, which is why it's of global importance that every country has access to healthy and high-quality food. A fairly new development that could help people embrace a healthier diet, even if they have food insecurity, is a growing practice called produce prescriptions. And it's exactly what it sounds like. Instead of getting a medical prescription for your health, you're prescribed healthy food for free or at a discounted price. It's part of the Food is Medicine movement that aims to make nutrition accessible to as many people as possible. An example of this is FreshRx Oklahoma, a nonprofit food prescription program funded by the United States Department of Agriculture. They collaborate with numerous clinics and health centers in Oklahoma to provide produce prescriptions for people with diabetes. They use local doctors to monitor patients during a 12-month program, local farmers to provide fresh produce every 2 weeks, and nutritionists to educate patients on healthy eating. The next cornerstone to improve our overall health and general life expectancy is physical activity. Did you know that when humans reach the age of 30, our bodies and many of their basic functions start declining by 1-2% every year? Exercise, however, has been shown to cut that decline to just 0.5% each year. In the long run, this adds up. The research points to people with inactive lifestyles losing around 70% of their functions by age 90, while those who exercised only lost 30%. Combination exercises have proven to make a real difference in the health of both young and old. A huge study involving just under 100,000 people 60 years and older showed that those who did moderate to vigorous aerobic exercises as well as weightlifting on a regular weekly basis had a 41% drop in mortality risk than those who did neither. They also had a lower risk than those who only did either aerobic or weightlifting exercises. The 2018 Physical Activity Guidelines for Americans recommended that adults should spend 150 to 300 minutes per week doing moderate exercises, and between 75 to 150 minutes per week on vigorous exercises. But another massive study, this time involving almost 120,000 adults over the course of 30 years, found that those who exercised 2 to 4 times more than the prescribed guidelines had up to 38% lower risk of death from life-threatening diseases. This was especially true for participants who performed more moderate exercises weekly, such as walking and low-intensity exercises. The potential here is significant, because as more people embrace healthier physical lifestyles, the global life expectancy will rise even more. While it's vital that people be more active in order to up their life expectancy, it's also crucial for our bodies to get proper rest and recovery time. That's why the next cornerstone of a long life is sleep. Getting proper sleep is essential to our health and can reduce our risk of dementia and heart attacks. When we sleep, our bodies heal themselves by repairing injured or sore muscles, flushing out toxins, and releasing hormones necessary for our biological systems. When we don't sleep well, these essential restorative processes can't fully happen. This is when we run the risk of developing a variety of health problems, including high blood pressure and insulin resistance. This study shows that men with an optimized sleep routine can live 4.7 years longer than those who don't have it. For women, the benefit is an extra 2.4 years. So, to all of my friends who made fun of me for sleeping too much during college, told you so. That may not seem like a lot, but combined with overall healthier habits, it could still lower the risk of health conditions associated with mortality. Experts suggest that there are five factors that determine whether or not we get quality sleep. The first has to do with how long we sleep, with an ideal range being 7 to 8 hours a night. Also, the easier we fall asleep, the better our overall sleep quality. Staying asleep and not constantly waking up at night is another factor, as is the absence of using sleep medication. The final factor has to do with how rested we feel when we wake up. A healthy sleep routine should make people feel well rested for at least 5 days a week. Many doctors and scientists agree that people with the right sleeping habits can live a longer life. While more studies are still needed, we now have sleep clinics all over the world where practitioners can monitor a sleeper's brainwaves and analyze their sleeping patterns. They can also diagnose and treat sleeping disorders like sleep apnea, and that's known to shorten people's lifespans. It's pretty clear that if we can optimize our sleep, we can increase our lifespans, as well as our future life expectancy numbers. Studies have shown over and over that a general healthy lifestyle can offset the effects of life-shortening genetics by up to 62%. This is why eating healthy, exercising, sleeping well, and avoiding bad habits like smoking and drinking alcohol are considered to be the optimal healthy lifestyle. Some people have even made it their life's mission to do everything they possibly can to improve their longevity. One man named Brian Johnson even went viral on the internet when he shared his health regimen that he calls Project Blueprint. The 46-year-old Johnson calls himself the most measured person in the world. He claims that he has 85% less inflammation than the average 18-year-old. And that his aging rate is 99% slower than that of a 20-year-old. He counts himself among the top 1% of optimal sleepers in the world and the top 1.5% of cardiovascular capacity under 18-year-olds. Project Blueprint involves him taking more than 100 supplements a day. Johnson also takes remacepin, the drug believed by some to control aging. He eats just under 2,000 calories daily and only before 11 a.m. He exercises for an hour every day and has as many as 30 doctors constantly monitoring his health. He also has a strict sleeping routine that sees him wearing blue light blocking glasses for 2 hours before going to bed at 8:30 p.m. Early. Exposure to blue light from digital devices has been shown to disturb a person's sleeping patterns. Johnson does all of this with the hope of retaining what he calls the body of an 18-year-old. He's dabbled in a variety of experimental treatments, like full body red light therapy, which is said to improve cell function and reduce inflammation. He's also undergone blood plasma transfusions courtesy of his teenage son, but stopped it after it yielded no beneficial results. It's also just kind of creepy. This might all seem somewhat extreme and something only a millionaire like Johnson can afford. Still, it's fascinating to see how people are trying to increase their lifespans and learn from the data that accompanies these experiments. But as always, we want to know, what's your take on this topic? Would you also try strict health routines like Brian Johnson's? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. As always, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in our next weekly dose of good news episode.